Romans chapter 8, verse 1, King James Version. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. Amen. Who walk not after the flesh. But after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ hath made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. Amen. Now, there is therefore no condemnation, verse 1, to them who are in Christ. Now, this is amazing. You are not condemned in spite of all that you've done. Amen. And when you meet a prisoner, I mean, who's done something wrong, you realize that he can't easily come out of prison, isn't it? And that when the judge says, this is it, sorry, you have to go to jail. It's scary. Is there anybody here who's been to jail and wants to share that testimony? What it's like? Come. Now tell me, what is it like when the judge, what does the judge say when you are being sent to jail?
The judge, when I was being sent to jail, he said, at first he said that you've been found guilty, and then he said that if you don't like that part, you're not going to like the next part, and the next part was that you're not going to go back outside, you're going to go downstairs straight into a cell. And then straight to prison. And that's the first thing he said to us. Yeah.
And how did you feel?
At that time, I think I thought, it is what it is. If we get there and we have to start fighting, then we start fighting. But at that point, I wasn't scared. But prior to that, I was scared. Because I thought that straight away, people are going to start stabbing you and stuff like that. But at that point, I wasn't really scared. So, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And you couldn't go home?
Oh no, I couldn't go home at all. Even my belt, I couldn't take my belt there. I couldn't take my tie, because I had a nice pink shirt, nice trousers, but they said I can't take my tie, because I might strangle myself, so yeah.
Who else is there? There was somebody else. Come. What happened to you?
So I was with him.
And you were condemned by the judge?
Yeah, I was condemned by the judge.
To go to jail for how long?
Well, they gave me 6.5 years.
Wow.
But there was a bit of grace because I served like 3 and a bit.
Yeah. And you were sent there. So can you imagine being sent there for life?
Yeah.
Did you meet people in jail who were there for life?
We met quite a lot of people in jail that were there for life.
You tell us, you met people who were there for life.
Yeah. We met a number of people actually.
Brighten his microphone. Increase the treble on his mic.
Hello. Many people who were there for life, a lot of them, they're finished. I mean, yeah, they just don't have a brain anymore, to be honest. They were nice people, though. I'm not going to lie. They do say good afternoon and good morning. But apart from that, their mind is not correct. Like, they don't understand life, like, at all anymore, because they've been institutionalized. Like, everything they know is, like, for the last 30 years, like, I met someone for the last, that was in there for about 29 years, and he doesn't know anything. Doesn't even know a mobile phone. Prophet was talking about computers. Some of them don't even know that a computer's even come out. Like, it's really, really bad. So when you're trying to explain life to them on the outside, they're talking about something else from, I mean, back in 19, whenever. So it's pretty difficult for them, to be honest. Yeah. And then some of them don't even know when they're coming out. So some of them need to, like, go through a thing called parole. But to even get to parole, they're even struggling to get there. So, yeah. Parole is like something where they have to go through, so they've been sentenced and then they have to go through another court case to even say that, can we let you out? Then they have to check like their mental health and stuff like that, because they don't feel like they're capable to come outside and then be normal again. They don't think they'll ever be normal, ever, ever again.
Yes.
I think one of the worst cases would be like something called IPP, where they get sent to prison and they might give them a year. Or they say they've given you a year on good behavior, but then a lot of them stay for like 15 years, 20 years. So it's almost like every single time, I think that's when parole happens, right? Yeah. Every single time after the year, they have another assessment and then they extend it for another year, another year, another year, indefinitely.
Yeah, so that one is worse. So they don't actually have an end date. At least the people that maybe have murdered someone, they might say after 30 years, then... But they have no end date whatsoever. So, and it could have been a small crime, like, well, I say small. Well, I mean, no crime is small, but...
Like arson.
Yeah. Yeah.
A bit of fire.
So you were condemned. But the Bible says there is... And you were condemned. So can you imagine if that crime that you committed put you there for life?
I don't want to imagine it, to be honest.
You don't want to imagine it?
Because it would have been scary.
It would have been scary.
Yeah.
And all of us, all the crimes, like, there's nobody like you in heaven. Like, who has done the bad things you've done? There's nobody like you in heaven. Because all the people in heaven are clean. And so even the small things you've done, like the negative thoughts you've had, they don't work in heaven at all. So now, the things you've done, and would you agree that even the judge who sentenced you didn't really know how bad you were?
Yeah, he didn't know how bad. Because I think even when they were going through... Say, for example, they had, like, a hierarchy. He was at the top, by the way. And,
forgive.
And then they put me at number four or five. But really and truly, and I'm not even boasting, when I joined the enterprise, they could have put me at number two. So he didn't know how bad I really was, because the evidence against me wasn't a lot. I was bad. He didn't know. Yeah.
Because he's a human judge.
Yeah.
Yes, he's a human judge. And God knows everything. So God's judgment will be more accurate. Isn't it? And you, what's your name?
Charles.
Will you agree that you shouldn't be free by now?
Yes, I'll definitely agree.
You shouldn't be free.
I shouldn't.
Yeah, you shouldn't be free. But you are free. Yes. By the grace. By some grace. You get it. And you're now facing God. You know, and God says to you, there's no condemnation at all. Like, he's okay. He's okay with you. Yeah. Like, and he knows even more than the judge. And he rather is okay. And how come he's okay with you? He rather is okay. And he says to you that there's no condemnation. Why? Because of the gospel. You see, the gospel of Jesus Christ, which you have received. Oh, yes. Yes. So you stand, I stand before him guilty and unworthy. Yes. How can I be forgiven and made holy? I think there's a song like that, isn't it? I think there's a song like that. Yes. Yes. Oh, yes. This is why, you know, and I thank God. Do you know what? When I asked for who's been to prison, you raised your hand and you came, both of you. You see, because you know what is happening to you. You are starting to be healed. Not you are starting, but you are quite advanced. You are quite advanced in your healing. Because there are more than five people here who didn't raise their hands. Maybe they want to raise their hands now. Yeah. There are more people here like that. Yes, one. Where are the rest? Yeah. You see, the healing comes when you can testify readily. It's like, look, I've been in there. Yeah. Oh, there are some who should have gone. They didn't get you. The other person should come if you want to come, because you are being healed. Now listen. You are being healed. So this is the point that I'm making. The point is not that thing has not happened to anybody, but you being healed of it. Yes. So you see, God is healing you of prison. Yes. Another one. Don't worry, no shaking. Yes. God is healing you. And there's some more people. Yes. So God is healing you of going to prison. Yes. Yes. And it's not an easy... When you've been to prison, every form you fill, have you been to prison before? You have to write yes. You have to fill everything. There are some countries which will not accept you. If you go, I want to be a missionary here, or I want to go here, they'll ask for a criminal record, police report, many things. Yeah, it changes your life. But you see, this is what happens, and then you can be healed. You can be healed. Amen. And you can be, where are the eight points? You can be totally normal. And what about you? You are also there.
Yeah, I was there. I was with these two.
Oh, you're with these guys. Yeah. Yes.
It's ridiculous, but it happened. Okay. You can only blame you, you know. It's terrible.
Hello, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here, yeah.
Yeah. And you see, and your beard is to frighten people, or what is it for? You see, no US president has ever had a beard like this, or somebody who's trying to win a public relations or give a certain impression has ever had such a beard. No, that's just by the way. Yeah, it's true. Have you ever seen a bearded US president standing and campaigning for elections and is trying to make people accept him and so on?
No, it's rememberable, it's though.
Huh?
It's rememberable, though.
It's what?
It's rememberable. The beard. Memorable.
Memorable.
George Washington had a beard.
Memorable.
Memorable. That's what I meant. Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, so you are being healed. Shh. And that is why it says, keys to healing. Know that you are not the only one. Or there's others here. Do not be overcome with self-pity. Believe that you can be completely normal. Yes. Completely. Make sure that you do not try to revenge on people who have done things to you. Do you feel like revenging? Have you felt like revenging?
At all.
Beautiful.
Actually, at first, I wanted something bad to happen to the judge. Because I felt like he was just,
he was harsh. But he wasn't harsh, but I just felt like he was harsh. So at first, we wanted some. I wanted it anyway.
Yes.
Not anymore, though, I mean.
Oh, yes. Yeah. So you see, you are being healed when all those things are dropping off. Then pray for healing. Pray about it. And then watch for signs that you are not healed. That's the next number six. What are the signs that you are not healed? When it even occurs to you, what are the signs when it even occurs to you to go back to such things? When you have the feeling of revenge for somebody, when you don't admit clearly, yes, and somebody who has been to prison and you come stand here and say, yes, I was there. It's a sign that you are healed or you are getting healed. Yeah. Oh, yes, definitely. But if you can't say, I don't want anybody to know when you relate with people, oh, yeah, when you fill in a form. So why didn't you go on the mission? You don't tell them because the criminal report said this and that. You tell them that, oh, I had asthma and I wasn't, you know, I hear where we are going is very dusty and I'm not part of the people. I had hay fever. Yes. Oh, yes. Different stories. The Fanti Kenke, one secret leads to another. And use positive confessions of faith to drive home the healing. Yes. Oh, I remember a pastor. He said to me, I remember when the judge said to me, I sentence you to 25 years in prison. Yes, for killing somebody. He killed someone and he was in prison. He's a pastor that I know. Yeah, he said I was sentenced, an American, a white American pastor from Texas, I think. He said I was sentenced to 25 years. I remember when the judge looked at me, you are sentenced you to 25 years. He said he was in a prison when a pastor came to him to preach to him in the prison. And he gave his life to Christ. And when he came out, he became a son to the pastor. Yes. And that pastor, who he became a son to, recently was dying. He died during COVID. And when he couldn't breathe, he called this pastor. And he called him. He said, listen, I'm dying. You are my favorite son. My what? My favorite son. Yes. And he told him, look after my wife. And that's the kind of person he has become. A murderer. Witness to and evangelized from prison. And he doesn't deny it. He says, look, I did it. I killed the person. And he said, when my daughters were getting married, I told the people who were marrying my daughters that, listen, this is something that I've done before. So as you are marrying my daughter, you should be aware that the father of my wife has killed somebody before. That the potential is there. Now, I mean, he says it like a joke all the time. He said, be careful. Oh, yes. But you see, it shows that he's healed of it. It shows that he's healed of it. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And I thank God. You see, what does he say? There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. So even the part that the judge didn't see. Are you with me? Yeah. Let your mind be stable. Even the part that the judge didn't see. And the part that the judge didn't see. Which God saw. You see, even that is covered and washed by the blood of Jesus. How can I be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ? Something, look at what it has done for me. And you are accepted. And when you are healed, you can stand on it. And that healing, stand up here, you stand on this, will make you have a platform which others don't have. Yes. To make you have a platform which others don't have. Yes. Yes. Yeah, because you're standing on something that others haven't been. You tell people, listen, I've been to prison before. All the things in the Bible about judgment, court, judgment, eternity, punishment, condemnation. You can explain it better. Yes, you tell people, the people you met in prison, I've been in there. I don't need somebody to tell me about hell. I've been to hell and I've come out. Oh, yes. Your preaching will be nicer than my preaching. Yes. Oh, yes. You tell them about each person you encountered. You remember the stories and you tell them, I met one guy, I tell you. One time I was in the jail. In the night, in the dark, I met this guy. What he said, he said this. Your preaching will be very powerful. Yeah. Oh, yes. 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 Yeah, you'll be preaching from the power of that experience. And that's why you'll be standing on that platform, which I don't have because I've never been to prison. Yeah. I've never been to prison. I can just theorize. I can just imagine. But I can never say what you can say. That's why Kenneth Hagin used to make a big banner. Come and listen to the man who has been to hell before. Come and listen to the man who's been to hell. Yes. Because he had a vision where he went to hell. So this is how he advertised his Saturday programs. Yes. Everybody and what he has. Yes. He's gone there before. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Beautiful. So, 1, 2, 3. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Forever. In Jesus' name.
Stand before you guilty and unworthy. How can I be forgiven and made holy?
Made holy.
Though I know I break your heart, you promised I could start all over and all the things I've done.
I love this, Jesus.
You place them each.
There's therefore no condemnation. No more.
Into the sea of forgetfulness. You placed all of my sins. I'm the one who keeps reminding you over and over again. Into the sea of forgetfulness, as far as the east from the west. 70 times 7, you've forgiven me, and you keep cleansing me, placing my sins,
placing my sins
into the sea of forgetfulness.
Come on, sing.
Oh, yeah. You welcome me with open arms of mercy. In spite of all that I've done, you still keep loving me.
Jesus.
And I only need to ask, and you erase all of my past forever. My debts have all been paid.
My debts.
And they have all been washed away. Into the sea of forgetfulness, you placed all of my sins. Lord, I'm the one who keeps reminding you over and over again. Into the sea of forgetfulness, as far your unfailing love that covers me in all my multitude of sin. It's your steadfast love that keeps reminding me I'm forgiven. Into that sea of forgetfulness, you blessed all my sins. Lord, I'm the one I keep reminding.
There's no condemnation. There's therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. God bless you guys. Amen. Sit down. Beautiful. I hope you remember Romans 8 verse 1. Now, the law of the Spirit of life has made me free from the law of sin and death. Verse 2. Which means that there is a law that when you sin, you die. When you sin, you die. So the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free. So then that means that the law of the sin of death is not working on you. That's why they ask questions. Where are you resident? Where are you resident? Because when you are resident somewhere, certain laws will apply. When you are not resident in this country, certain laws will not apply. So the laws, that's why one of the things people want to know is, where are you resident? Because this law will not work for you. This law is going to work. So when you are in Christ, the law of sin and death is not applicable to you in the same way. Sin, you die. Sin, you die. Sin, you die. No, there's another law. The law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus. That is the law that you have life in Christ. That's the law. When you come to Christ, you have life. So the other guys who went to prison and some of the other people in the prisons, you get it? They are people who maybe if they don't know Christ, the law of sin and death is the only law that is working for them. What law is applying to them? Law of sin, you die. Sin, you die. Sin, you die. That's the law of sin and death. Then there's the law of the life. The law, read it. It says, the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. In other words, being resident in Christ, the law of sin and death is not applying to you. But the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus, new life in Christ Jesus. I found a new life in Christ Jesus. I have new life in Jesus Christ. Amen. So verse 6. For to be carnally minded, all right, is death. And to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Beautiful. So you need to be spiritually minded about everything. There are some people who are just carnally minded. You see a man who wants to marry you. You say, is he tall? Is he short? Is he from Kenya or is he from Seychelles? Is he fair or is he dark? Midnight or desert? Which one is he? That's the law. That's carnally minded. Everything about you is flesh. Your mind is only carnally minded. Everything is carnally minded. What type of person is he? Who is the one preaching? What color is he? What nationality? What accent? These are all carnal things. But spiritually minded is life and peace. Listen, don't listen to people preaching. based on carnal mindedness. You base it on the spiritual. And those who are carnally minded, unfortunately, are missing a whole lot of things. There are few churches that are gathered like this. Look at what is today. Wednesday, as if we don't know, we don't go to school or we don't go to work. Yes. We are here as if there's nothing like school. Or there's nothing like work. Huh? Christianity is now something that is, if you are carnally minded, just flesh minded, you miss out. Yes, to be carnally minded is death. Because truly speaking, a lot of the Christianity is not in the hands of the former John Wesley's and William Booth's, who are all Englishmen, real Englishmen. Or my pastor, Pastor Michael Bassett, a real Englishman. He was a real Englishman. Not our type of Englishman. Real Englishman. He was not from Poland or from Romania or anything like that. He was a real Englishman from England. Yes. He ordained me. He made me a pastor. He ordained me. Yeah. Right here in London. Yeah. But if you are carnally minded, say, oh, what's the pastor like? Where is he from? That's carnally minded. You're going to miss out on most of what God is doing. Even I will miss out on most of what God is doing if I'm carnally minded. Because most of the people that I've received from were Americans. Yes, I received from American, which was Kenneth Hagin. Benny Hinn was American or Palestinian. Do you see? Fred Price. If I'm carnally minded, and nowadays, when the people that become a blessing, either they are Nigerian or Congolese or some other nationality. But mostly, that is where people are from. Yeah. If you are going to be carnally minded, it leads to death. But spiritually minded, I'm looking at the spiritual gifts the person is carrying. And the anointing that is there. Yes. To be carnally minded, it brings lots of difficulty. Lots of difficulty. So you cannot afford to be carnally minded. You look at the hall, say, how nice is the hall? Is it air conditioned? Is it this? Are the girls having a lot of makeup? Are they dressed like this? Do they behave like this? That's carnally minded. It leads to death. You die spiritually. But spiritually minded, you think of spiritual things. If you're choosing a beloved, you cannot afford to be purely carnally minded. You can't afford that. Just thinking carnally. Oh, what is this person like? What is this person like? What are the carnal features of the person? What's his family? What is this? Does he have mental health issues? Does his family have inherited diseases? Does he have this sickness? Does he have that sickness? What sicknesses do the family have? All those are good questions, but it's still carnal. What about spiritual? What about spiritually minded? Is the person spiritual? Because every man, you see, even a young man, they have different people that they are interested in. One young man, 20 years old, he's interested in multiple girls. Because that's just a normal male. A normal male in nature is interested in multiple girls. Yes. So if he's not spiritual, nothing is going to control him from make him behave in a different way. He needs to be spiritual. Otherwise, he just cannot change. You just cannot change. You just be a normal man. So you should think spiritually about people. Think spiritually about church. You don't go to a church because it's nearby. So this one is nearby. Or this is very convenient. Just get up. It's next door. Actually, the church is upstairs. Or the church is downstairs. So I just go downstairs and I go to church. It's in the community center in your flat. Or it's in the common room. In your uni. So it's right there. So I go to church. That's carnally minded. But God is looking for you to be spiritually minded. Yes. So always remember this verse. When you start thinking about things, say to yourself, I want to think about this in a spiritual way and not to be carnally minded. Carnally minded, you soon be out. Yes. Carnally minded, you still be out. Yeah. Most of the great, what the biggest church in the world? The biggest church in the world is in Nigeria. Yeah. The biggest building in the world is in Nigeria. The greatest prophets that are operating today, they are from different countries. So from Malawi, Zimbabwe, Congo, Ghana. That is it. You rarely, and you see real gifts. Real gifts that are working, you just wonder it as if it's magic. Yeah. So I want to be spiritually minded about everything. Amen. Because the carnal mind is in enmity against God. For it is not subject to the law of God. Are you there? Amen. So that they that are in the flesh cannot please God. Once you are fleshly, you can't please God. If you follow your flesh, what does your flesh want to do? Romans chapter 8, verse 8. This television is off. Somebody put it back on. Romans chapter 8, verse 8. What does it say? They that are in the flesh cannot please God. Do not operate and live in the flesh. Amen. Amen. They that are in the flesh. Now, verse 9. But you are not in the flesh, but in the spirit, if so be that the spirit of God dwells in you. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you. All right? He that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you. What does it mean? The spirit of God is going to make your bodies come alive. Amen. Which is what I was sharing with you earlier today when we were praying. Verse 11, change the version, please. Change the version. It says, the spirit of God who raised Jesus from the dead lives in you. And just as God raised Christ Jesus from the dead, he will give life to your mortal bodies by this same spirit living within you. So it's like what he was saying was that Moses continued to be alive because of the Holy Spirit. Yeah. So it looks like your connection to the Holy Spirit is directly connected to the life in you and your ability to continue living. Amen. Are you there?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Verse 12. So everybody, God is telling you, you want to live, you need to be connected to the Holy Spirit. Need to be connected to the Holy Spirit. Lift your hand and say, I want to be connected. I want to receive the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Verse 12. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh, to live after the flesh. For if you live after the flesh, or if you follow your flesh, you shall die. But if you, through the help of the Holy Spirit, mortify the deeds of your body, you shall live. Read it again. Verse 12. Verse 12. And change the version, please. It says no signal again. All right. Now, notice change the version. Verse 12. Therefore, dear brothers, you have no obligation to do what your sinful nature urges you to do. For if you live by its dictates, you will die. But if through the power of the Spirit you put to death the deeds of your sinful nature, you will live. Amen. So through the Holy Spirit, you can mortify or kill the feelings of the of your flesh. Amen. Oh yes. Change the version. It says, if you live after the flesh, you will die. But if you, through the Spirit, through the Holy Spirit, that's your key. That's the key to your whole life. It's through the Holy Spirit, you mortify, you quench the behavior of the flesh, the feelings of the flesh, the attitudes of the flesh, the wickedness of your flesh. What's your flesh? Your flesh wants you to eat, to drink, to sleep, to have sex, to be jealous, to be angry, to be lazy. That's your flesh. All right? To gossip. So it's through the Holy Spirit. So listen, the deeds of your flesh, again, God is saying, be healed, yes, by the Holy Spirit. So, where are the points for healing? Where are the points for healing? Put the points back on. And one of the points for the healing is, now I'm adding point number 8. Yes. Pray for the Holy Spirit to help you to mortify the deeds of the flesh, because the flesh will want to bounce back. And the flesh will want to return to what it was used to. Yes. Oh, yes. Ah, your flesh is like an animal that has been trained. Yes. And that is why when they keep lions and things like that in certain places, they train them to eat food that they give them. They don't want them to chase anything, because then they will learn to attack. Are you with me?
Yes.
Yes. They learn to attack people because they just do what they've done. So point number 8 is, to pray for the Spirit to help you to mortify the flesh. Now, what is your flesh? Your flesh has learned some things. Yes. Some people masturbate 6 times a day. Some masturbate 3 times a day. Like it has to happen morning, afternoon, evening, or I don't know whether it's 3 times in a go. Yes. It's like 3 tablets a day. You know why I'm saying all this? I'm saying all these things because once your flesh is into certain things, right, you need to know that that's your flesh. It's going to be there unless through the Spirit. You are not, if through the Spirit, you can kill certain things. You know, one day somebody told me her whatever had traveled and was coming back. And there are people who love to eat when they travel for a long time. When they come back, I want to eat something that I like from home or from whatever. So I asked, what is the person asking for? So the person mentioned the food. I said, wow. What the person is mentioning, if it is given to me as a punishment, I'll even be begging. because the person wanted intestines. Intestine stew. Yes. Intestine stew. Huh? Intestines of a goat. Stew. Yes. And some other animals. Yes. Some people want to eat monkey. Yes. Monkey. Monkey, they want to have monkey meat. Stew. I don't know how they make it. Monkey. Yes. Now, why would somebody want to eat all these things? You get it? Because the person grew up eating those things. So your flesh is trained to eat intestine stews. And your flesh is trained to eat monkey. Or minky. Monkey. That's what your flesh loves. That's how fleshes are. I remember one brother, he came to stay in Ghana for some years. He said, I just want a hamburger. Because that he was from America. That's all that he knows. America, a hamburger. I just want a hamburger. I just want a hamburger. Yeah, hamburger. I want a hamburger. I want a hamburger. Because that's what his flesh knows. This is all that he's had. He's had hamburger and chips and McDonald's and Burger King and this. And I don't know what other had to have a hamburger. That's all that he's grown up. His flesh knows that. So your flesh is like a trained animal. And it always comes back to what it has learned. So if you, through the Spirit, where's my scripture? Through the Holy Spirit, don't mortify. Mortify means kill. The deeds of the flesh, of the body, is going to bounce back. You say, I need monkey now. I need monkey now. I need monkey. I need monkey now. I can't stay without monkey. I need a monkey. I want to eat a monkey. Hey! Are you listening to me? Yes. Yes. Now, well, there are certain countries you go to, you see them selling them. Monkey, they've hung it up there. And it's like monkeys and raccoons and antelopes, different animals. Oh yes, bats and everything. That's all, because your flesh has learnt it. When your flesh was having a great experience, what was your flesh eating? Monkey. When it comes to sexual things, what did your flesh learn? Yes. What did your flesh learn? If you learn perverted type of sex or variant types of sex or, normal sex in a certain way or I don't know what you learned. Do you see? You see, one day you get up, you said, I'm a Christian, I'm not a pastor, I'm serving the Lord. And then before you realize, your flesh will come and say, I want what? Monkey. Monkey sex. That is the danger. That is the danger of all these things that we engage in. Is that will it rise up again one day and come up, and then your whole flesh will say, this is all I want. I want monkey meat. Yeah. Hey. A dignified lady like you. You see that you'll be climbing the wall of your house. Your husband is in his room. And you are climbing the wall. Going out. To go. Because that is what you know. You've learned how not to be stable with one person. Yes, you must always have other people. And you've also learned only deception. So you are a natural deceiver. And the deception continues. You would think that marrying will make you normal. But one day, when you are married, and you find, your husband is not loving you the way you thought he would love you. Oh, yes. And there will come somebody who will say, your husband is not doing well. He also has girlfriends. Why do you bother to be faithful? These days, nobody is faithful. And then it stirs up your flesh. Because you only know deception. Yes. And before you realize, you are pregnant. And then you are now going to force him to come have sex with you so that you can ascribe the pregnancy to him.
Jacket.
It's called what?
Jacket. Yes, you put it on him.
Jacket. Wow. Yes. Monkey. Yes. That's why you have people married to beautiful girls and they just want to watch pornography. Yeah. I've seen it. Young people, 20s, they are married, got a nice, beautiful girl. All they want is pornography. But that's what they know. Yeah. They look at the pornography to watch pornography. When there's a beautiful wife there, she's walking around. Naked. Walking around naked. I hear she's naked. But still. Monkey. I want my monkey meat. I want my intestine stew. Yes. I want to eat a raccoon. I want to eat a raccoon. Or a leopard leg. I want leopard leg meat. Roasted leopard. Yes. Leopard pie. Pray for your children. How many of you have tasted some monkey meat before? Monkey sex. Nobody understands what I'm saying. There's nobody here. I am saying... Monkey stands for, you know what monkey stands for. How many have had some monkey experiences? How many are hoping that one day you're not going to call for your monkeys? Yes. Yes, you are used to it. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. When you see people eating the food that they grew up eating at home, how many have seen somebody eating something it made you feel sick when you saw? Yes. Hey. Recently, a brother sent me a picture of white rice with fried termites. Yes. I think it's a Kenyan delicacy, isn't it? Bishop Kent, I don't know whether you can confirm. It's a Zimbabwean speciality. Huh? It's what?
Caterpillars.
Caterpillars. Huh? Yeah. But this was a Kenyan brother who sent it to me. And it was his dinner. He said, it is so. He said, I have missed this thing so much. I've missed this. He said, this is my favorite food. Termites. If you're better, you can learn how to fry the termites. Yes. How to catch them and enjoy them. Oh, what have you been learning in your private room? Huh? I'm asking you, what have you been learning? How many have learned some termite and some monkey tricks? Indoor tricks. Lift your hand, let me pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray right now. And we thank you that every flesh trick that we've learned, in the name of Jesus, it will not rise up. And even if it rises up, thank you that we will mortify by the Holy Spirit every flesh trick and every flesh work by the Holy Spirit. By the Holy Spirit. By the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. We pray with thanksgiving. Amen. All right. Now the famous verse 14. As many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are what? In other words, they are not human anymore. Yeah. Son of God is like God. I mean, God will give birth to God. Would man not give birth to man? God gives birth to God. Or let's say, supernatural being. Will he not give birth to a supernatural being? So as many as are led, that is how to be filled with the Spirit, is to be led by the Spirit. The Spirit must lead you. That's what makes you supernatural. Once you are being led by the Spirit, you are being supernatural. And that makes you supernatural. So the Spirit will lead you. And most of the time, the Spirit will lead you away from what will defeat you. Yes. He will lead you. I will say, no, no, don't go here. Don't go here. So being filled with the Spirit is largely being led when he can lead you. It's the, because one of the main things he comes to do when he comes to our life is to lead us. God wants to lead you. God wants to take over leading you. And as many as are led by the Spirit, they are supernatural beings. So my supernaturalness, the level of my supernaturalness is directly connected to the level of my ability to being led. So the level of supernatural power and involvement of God in my life is directly connected to how much he can lead me. Because as many as are led by the Spirit, they are sons of God. What is the verse before this? Verse 13. If you live after the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you mortify the deeds of the body, you shall live. Then immediately he says, for as many as are led by the Spirit, they are sons of God. Which means that you are now elevated above the normal man who is flesh. And the normal man who is flesh, how are you like? What are you like? You are just going to eat the monkeys, you know, the termites, you know, the these things, you know, the hamburgers, you know, everything, you know, you what you know will just rise up and that's all you're going to do. Yes. And it's not good. Especially if you've had a background like yours. Yes. Are you listening to me? Oh, yes. So, thank God. Every experience you've had, the Spirit is going to lead you. Now, if the Spirit of God leads you to come to a camp meeting, where are you right now? You are not somewhere else. That's where you are. You are not somewhere else. You are here now. You could have been somewhere else. What would you be doing somewhere else? Monkey things. Yes. And God is setting you free. Amen. By the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. As many as are led. So, we are not ashamed of the gospel, because the gospel of Jesus Christ has changed our lives, and now we are even being led by the Spirit, and we are being shown by the Spirit to mortify the deeds of our flesh. Yes. Beautiful. Verse 15. For you have not received the spirit of bondage to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. For the Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not to be compared with with the glory that shall be revealed in us. Amen. 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 For the earnest expectation of the creature, change the version, please. All creation is waiting eagerly for that future day when God will reveal who his children really are. Yes, verse 20. Against its will, all creation was subject to God's curse, but with hope. Verse 21. The creation looks forward to the day when it will join God's children in glorious freedom from death and decay. What's the change diversion? Change to jams. Jams. All right? Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption. All right? Into the glorious liberty. Now, everybody say corruption.
Corruption.
Now, corruption, right, is spoiling. You see? And you are already spoiled. We are in corruption. Yes. In fact, the Bible even says when you are buried, you'll be buried in corruption. Now, corruption is not something that can be reversed. Like if you take meat or food, you cannot reverse the corruption when it's getting spoiled. You can only stop it or temporarily stop it. So corruption never reverses. And so you notice that there's some spoiling about yourself that cannot really be reversed, but can only be halted. Yes. And that's what's happening to this world. The whole world is in corruption. And that's why it's not getting better. It's only getting worse. It can only be slowed down, put in a freezer to hold on, because it's going down. Yeah. We have to be careful. Anyone who jokes with the idea of corruption, you don't really know what it means. But our bodies are corrupt. Yes, our flesh is corrupt. Yes, it's all corruption. Are you listening to me? Yes. For we know that the whole creature groaneth and travaileth in pain until now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit. Even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the redemption of our body. For we are saved by hope. Verse 24. But hope that is seen is not hope. Verse 25, if we hope that we see not, then we do with patience work for it. Verse 26, likewise, the Spirit helps our infirmity. Again, it looks like in this salvation that we are enjoying, we have to look always to the Spirit. He says, the Spirit helps our infirmities. You know, we are weak and we are corrupted. For we know not what to pray for as we ought. But the Spirit himself makes intercessions for us with groanings that cannot be uttered. So once again, the Spirit is helping us in this corruption. It's helping us to overcome the flesh, the Spirit of God. That's why you must love the Holy Spirit. You must desire the Holy Spirit. You must pray for the Holy Spirit. For me, I'll say 90% of my prayers are for the Holy Spirit nowadays. If you ask me, what am I praying about? Almost all the time, I'm praying for the Holy Spirit. I used to say that I don't pray for myself. But for some time, I only pray for myself. Just pray for the Holy Spirit. I feel if I can have more of the Holy Spirit, I'll be okay. Yeah. It's the Spirit that's helping our weaknesses. The weakness of not even knowing the topic to pray for. Not even knowing what to pray for. Yes. So, we must see that even as God has saved us, we can see that we are weighed down by the flesh. We are weighed down by the flesh. Everything wants to attach to us. Gambling also wants to hold on to us. Is there any gambler here? You are a gambler or a former gambler. Who is this? Morris? Yes. And another one, come. Why is it that these things want to hold us? Come. Why is it that they want to hold on to us? I mean, if you go and gamble once, why don't you just go, okay, I've gambled. And I lost it and I don't come back. Come. Gamblers are being said. Anybody is into gambling, come to the front. I'm going to pray for you right now. All gamblers to the front. Former gamblers or gamblers. Tell us. Gambling.
Yes. So I started gambling from around the age of 16.
And you're how old now?
24. Yes. I stopped around the age of 20. It started off quite innocent. It would just be casual bets, £5, £10, football accumulators, just to try and make a bit of money. But then there was a season of my life where I won quite a lot. So I feel like the devil deceived me into thinking that this was a fast track to prosperity. So I started...
Fast track to prosperity.
Yeah. So I began to gamble bigger and bigger amounts. From £5 to £50 to £100 to £500 to £800, at a point even £1,000.
£1,000?
Yes, on one single accumulator. And I could lose it, win it. Just, it was a cycle.
£1,000?
Yes.
When we are in church and we are saying, give an offering of £1,000.
Mercy. And even as you mentioned church, Daddy, I remember a day where I was in church with my friend David. He's here somewhere. And he was sitting next to me and I was gambling in church. Yes.
We're having church. I was on your phone.
I was in the church service.
On your phone?
On my phone, yes.
Gambling?
Yes.
While the pastor was preaching?
Yes.
I hope nobody here is gambling as we are preaching. Yes.
And my friend David looked at me and said, like, I know that you gamble, but we're in church, so you should try and stop. And I just dismissed him as like, I was so deep into gambling that I wasn't even aware of where I was doing it and when I was doing it. I did it whenever I wanted to. And I remember another day, I had many different episodes of gambling where I was in my university room on my own. And, you know, I needed money desperately. So I said, you know what, let me just find some money and place an accumulator. So I remember I placed, I think it was a £800 bet at the time to try and get...
You didn't have money.
I didn't have money. Yes. I didn't have money. But in my mind at the time, the best way I thought to make quick money was through gambling. So I placed an £800 bet and it was on a single game. So
soccer?
Yes, football.
Football?
Yes. On a random league. It's not even a league that I watched. I just saw it and said, let me just place the bet. And I remember sitting down on my chair, you know, glued to my chair because I'm tense. I don't have money, but I'm just trying to be
a game
smart.
Of soccer.
Yes.
As to how the game will end.
Yes. For a team to win.
11 players versus 11 yes. players. £800.
Yes.
And you needed money.
Yes.
Okay.
Mercy.
Satan is wicked, though.
He's wild. So yes, I was watching the game and at a point I was winning. And the way accumulators work is that when the result is favoring the bet that you've placed, the cash out, yes, you can either back out or stay in, but the cash out begins to go up and up. So there was a point where the cash out was around 1,300, 400. So, you know, even as a sensible person, even though you're gambling, you can just say, okay, let me cash out and I've made a win. But I was so greedy for money that I said, no, let me wait till the end of the game. So I was waiting. And then, unfortunately for me at the time, the opposite team scored. So now I was losing the bet and my money was about to go. And even as you say, Satan is wicked, it's very wild, Daddy, because I was a Christian at the time. I was born again. I spoke in tongues. And I remember when the team scored, I even tried to pray for God to help me. Yes. Like, and not like a casual prayer, like, oh, God, please help me. Speaking in tongues fervently, like.
For the team to win.
Yes, fervently. I remember crying out to God fervently. As
Lord, let the team win.
It's wild. But the team never won. And I lost the money.
You lost all the 800 pounds.
I lost it.
That's amazing. And if you don't take care, this thing will come back. So, everything that Satan brings, it wants to stay. Yes. And it wants to come back. Yeah. So, we know not what to pray for. As we ought. But the Spirit is going to help our infirmities. Yes. Yeah. You know, years ago, I started gambling also. Of course, with peanuts. And a sister said to me, first, because you had no verse to say, don't gamble. But 1 Thessalonians 5:22, she gave me that verse. You see, that was the Spirit. He said, abstain from all appearances of evil. Now, not that it's evil, but appearance of evil. Yeah. And there are a lot of things like that. It does. It's not evil officially, but what's the appearance of evil? Yeah. So it's like, I just didn't. It was nothing. I never gambled seriously. I didn't find it, whatever. But I know it destroys lives. Yeah. So the Spirit, He's helping our weaknesses. Oh, yes. The Spirit helps us. It's the Holy Spirit. Pray for the Holy Spirit. All these things, I tell you, they are attractive. They keep on edging you more. Do it again. Try this time. Try it again. Do more. Yes. Yes. Go deeper. Go deeper. So every weakness by the Holy Spirit. Yes. Line up here, all of you guys. Yes. Lift your hands. I thank God for those who came forward. No, go back a little. Go back a little. Go back a little. Yes. Lift your hands. As soon as I touch you, as soon as I touch you, all right, you are going to be set free. I need to make physical contact with you. Yes. I need to make physical contact with you. It's a big foundation of your life. Who has laid hands on you before? Amen. Father, I thank you for all these. I thank you. Everyone standing, please. Every standing. Where is she? Come on. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Be delivered. Be delivered. Wave of the Holy Spirit. Be free. Jesus. Oh, yes. Let the Holy Spirit help your infirmity. Let the Holy Spirit help you. Help your infirmities. Let the Holy Spirit help your infirmities. Mandala makabarandala mandala mandala. Be free from the devil. In the name of Jesus. 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 Come under Balabada Shabana. Fills this holy place.
Fills this holy place.
Thank you, Lord.
Wave after wave.
Thank you.
Wave after wave.
Thank you.
Glory of the Lord.
Everybody lift your hand. I feel like just
holy place. Wave after wave.
Thanks. Thanks, Holy Spirit. Thanks, Holy Spirit.
Glory.
Glory of the Lord. Glory of the Lord. Glory of the Lord.
Fill this holy place.
Lift your hand and receive the help of God. Lord, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Lift them down. Lift them down. Lift them down. Thanks for the power of the Holy Spirit.
Fill this holy place.
Fill this holy place. Come on. Power. 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 Glory of the Lord. Glory of the Lord. Glory of the Lord. Fill this holy place. Thank you, all this. Those who are down, just leave them on the ground. Listen, you are here, you have infirmities, and you really know that the Holy Spirit has to help you. I need you to come, because I just feel like praying for a few people. Come. You feel that you have infirmities. Just one line. Just one. No more than, if there's one line, the rest should wait. And lift your hands. I need the Holy Spirit to help me. Just one line, please. And lift your hands. No movement. No movement. No talking, please. Lift your hands. I'm just praying for a few people. Lift your hands. Everybody lift your hand. Every infirmity of your life, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit of God. Holy Spirit of God. There's power here right now. Receive. Receive a deliverance. Power belongs to God. Power belongs to God. Power belongs to God. In the name of Jesus. Receive the help of the Holy Ghost. Receive the help of the Holy Spirit. Thanks. Thanks. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit,
the Holy
Spirit, the Holy Spirit, the
Holy
Spirit, believe in the Holy Spirit from here. Thank you for the Holy Spirit. Thank you for the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. You are being filled. Receive. Receive from the Holy Ghost. Receive power. Receive help from the Spirit. Help from the Spirit. Help from the Spirit. Help from the Spirit.
Wave up to wave, the power.
belongs to God. Power belongs to God. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus is changing you, changing you. Everybody, listen. Romans 8:26. Likewise, the Spirit helps what? Our infirmities. Oh, yes. Lift your hands, all of you here. And everyone in the hall, there's power here. And that's why I'm praying for you. I'm just praying. Power belongs to God. Ota omala aramado sheba spirina shamba. Now, in front, receive the Holy Spirit. Receive, yes, 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 yes. Receive the Holy Spirit. Watch, 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 watch. Shuba kaba maranda lama sombele de magele.
Holy Ghost power.
Receive the Holy Ghost. Thanks. Thanks.
Holy Ghost power.
Receive. Receive.
Burn in me.
Receive.
Burn in me.
Receive.
Let your fire burn.
Receive the Spirit of the Lord.
Let the fire burn in me.
Thanks for your power. Real power, Lord. Thanks. It's flowing. It's flowing. It's flowing. It's flowing. It's flowing. Bala shubalade. Shiba. Balola mama kabala balo sandele mare. Amandele bala. Thanks. 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 Change. 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 By the Spirit of the Lord. By the Spirit of the Lord. By the Spirit of the Lord. Change
is coming. Change of the Holy Spirit.
Change of the Holy Spirit. Change of the Holy Spirit. Change, 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 change. Thanks, thanks, thanks. Lift your hands, everybody. Anointing.
Yes.
of Jesus. Now listen. Listen. We are reading Romans chapter 8 and verse 26. And what is it saying? Are you listening? What is it saying? It's saying that it is the spirit that helps our infirmity, means weaknesses. So the Holy Spirit, I'm telling you, you can't change unless the Holy Spirit helps you. You can't change. You can't make it. You can't make it in 5 years' time. I'm telling you, in 5 years' time, you can't make it without the Holy Spirit. I don't know anything else that can help you to survive 5 years of this Christianity. You can't break out of your weaknesses without the Holy Spirit. This Holy Spirit is what I'm praying for just a few people. And we continue. It's an interlude. It's an interlude in the reading. Lift your holy hands. Let His power and let His Spirit. Maharamindo ulbaga pendiri mashimbende lemono pelede bredele mondo bromalidi semande ne mambro bala kabarale. Have I prayed for these people already? Yeah, change. Leave them down. Just leave them down.
Touch my heart.
Touch my heart.
My hands and my
hands and my feet.
Fill my life.
Fire, Lord. Thanks. That's power. That is power. That is power. That is power. That is power. Oh, Marigele Bole Mobaradani Mole Bele Bele
Sweet,
sweet, sweet, watch. Malo Palamadore Mabale Mole. Receive power from the Lord. Power from the Holy Ghost. My God.
The Holy Ghost.
Now, listen. How many will agree with me? Are you listening? How many would agree with me that some of the addictions and desires You can't even explain them. Why? Why should I like this? Why should I want something like this? Why do I even go? What is driving? It's supernatural. And that's why if you don't also have a supernatural help, I wonder. I think the front is now overcrowded. Have I prayed for these ones? Leave them. Listen, the Bible says there are six foundations. Everybody say foundations. Foundation. Six foundations. These are foundations of Christianity, in Christianity. Like they are like very big things in Hebrews chapter 6. One of them, are you listening? Yes. I don't know if you are listening. Yes. If you are not listening, I will stop. One of the foundations, one of the big things is repentance. It's the first one. Yes. Repent, that's changing of the mind. When Christians set aside the attitude that I will change my mind this time, you miss a big area of your Christian life. Because one of the big foundations of Christianity is to change your mind. People don't change their minds. People don't change their minds. That is why people don't change. When you put that, I will not change my mind, that is repent. You've missed a big part of your whole Christian life. It's called a foundation. So beginning from today, the ability to change your mind and your thinking is happening to you. It's a foundation of all Christian life. And another foundation is laying on of hands, like contact. And you see that one man or boy whose genitals have entered into you has changed you. Or one girl that you have interacted with, or one other man you have interacted with, it has changed something. Or just one friend you've had, just a friend you've had, it has changed you. It's supernatural. And so this hand, my hand, because God told me, don't just talk to them. Pray for them. That's why I'm praying. And I'm hoping that before we finish, I would have prayed for everybody. Yes. The next line should be here quickly. The next line. Yes. Just one line, please. Just one line. No, this, I'm not praying for everybody now. This is just an interlude. We have prelude and interlude. This is an interlude. I'm reading the Bible. We are all reading the Bible together. But it is one of the foundations. It's one of the main things. Is to have hands laid on you. It's in the foundations. It is the fourth one. Yes, the fourth foundation. So I've spoken to you about the first foundation of Christianity and the fourth one. The first one is repentance, like my mind can change. Everybody say, my mind can change. Yes, my mind can change. Yeah. And that's why I've traveled all the way here. Do you see? I've traveled all the way so that I'll be physically in a room with you. Uh-huh. Then apart from physical in a room, I want to touch you. Yes, I want to just touch you. And I know that the Holy Spirit is touching you and filling you. Wave after wave of the Holy Spirit is coming on you. Lift your hands. Everyone, wherever you are, even if you don't get to the front now, don't worry. We are here today. We are here tomorrow. We are here the day after. Matarama shabara samanda mas banana rabala. Thank you. Thanks. 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 Oh, yes. In the name of Jesus. 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 Power! Power! Receive the power. There's power here. There's power here. There's power here, my dear. Balamo kobolo mandala mandala mandala. Oh yes. 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 There's power here. There's power here. There's power here. Balaga na 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 na. Your hands by the power of this foundation, the laying on of hands, receive a change in your life forever. Forever change. Receive, man.
God in the midst of thee, He will rest in
receive.
The He will joy
power change. Power change.
Joy over thee will
power
sing
change. Power change.
The Lord thy God in the midst
thanks
of thee.
Thanks.
He is a mighty
thanks.
God.
Thanks.
He
thanks.
Will
thanks. As I lay hands on this one, I'm laying hands on all. Receive the gift of God, the Holy Spirit. I want to feel you, Lord.
I
want to enjoy you, Lord.
Believe.
I want to love you, Jesus. Karaba, Karaba, Karaba.
Experience your mighty presence with me. Oh, the
yes.
Lord thy God
yes.
In the midst
yes.
Of
yes.
Me.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. He's changing you. 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 He's changing you.
He's changing you. God in the midst of thee, He will rest in His love.
Lift your hands. All right, this is the last group. Lift your hands. Thanks.
The Lord
by
my
these
God
hands,
in the
I establish you. I establish you. Barada Cosporalene. Receive the Holy Ghost.
God in the midst.
Yes. You are changing. Power belongs to God. All right. Everybody should go back to your seat. Is this a line to pray for? Okay, this is the last one. Lift your hands. We are going to continue. We will continue. Lift your hand. Receive now. Power. You are being changed by the power of the Holy Spirit. Oh, yes. Yes. You are being changed by the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus. Thanks. Receive gifts. Receive help from the Holy Spirit. Shakata. Kobara. Kobris Balani. Parima mamba 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 mamba. In the name of Jesus. Beautiful. Mala. Lift your hands. It's coming on you now.
Power. You are here. Power.
Oh, yes.
Your presence, Lord.
All right. You may be seated. Oh, yes. No, it's to be continued. You may be seated. On the ground, just leave them there, then enjoying the spirit. How many know the Holy Spirit is helping you? I want him to help me. Listen, I was born in 1963. It's been almost 60 years. And I can tell you that it's the Holy Spirit. Believe you me, although he is invisible, although you can't see him, and although you can't feel him most of the time, he is the reason why we are here. He is the one who makes whatever is happening real and powerful. He is the reason. It's the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit is not there, everything is dead. It's that Holy Spirit that we need. It's the one who's going to help you. Amen. And it says in verse 27, we know, and he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And verse 28, famous, all things, we know that all things work together for good to them that love God and to them who are called according to his purpose. I want to tell you something. All things work together for good. Every bad thing you've done, even Eh? Has anybody done anything bad? We are reading Romans. We are reading Romans because we are not ashamed of the gospel. It says all things work together for good. Everything in your life is going to work together. That means that if you've had 27, there's somebody here, you've had 27 boys. 27 boys or 27 girls. It's going to work together for good. Unless the Bible is not true. If you love God, there is a way it's going to work together. And I can even tell you one of the ways it's going to work together. Yeah. You see, one day you'll be at a certain place in the ministry and you will meet somebody who will remind you. When you talk to the person, you will remember someone in your life. And then the Holy Spirit will remind you and tell you, this one is deja vu. You have seen this one before. No need to waste your time. Yes, this leads to that. And it will somehow help you. Yes. And then you will meet someone else who will tell you something that someone has told you before, almost in the exact same words. And it will be your immunization or your vaccination. And you will remember the vaccination. That these same words, I've heard it before. It didn't go to a good end. And you'll be surprised. God will be working. You'll be preaching in your church. All 27 girls, you'll see all of them in the congregation. Each one of them. And you'll remember how worthless and useless it was. And that's what will even save you. Because to fall from that height, from the 27th floor, is different from falling from the first floor. Most people will survive from the first floor. But most people will not survive from the 27th floor. All things are going to work together for good to those who love God. That's why we are not ashamed of this gospel. It has changed our lives and has even brought us to a place where all things work together for good. Yeah, which is an amazing place to come to. You are like a Superman. Everything that happens will somehow work together for good. Somehow. Some you will see the good here. Some you see the good in eternity. You say, this bad thing that I experienced, it was actually a good thing. Yes. Walama domo sahal malagara. Listen to me. Are you listening? I'm telling you something. The day that Jesus died on the cross, John was standing there. Mary was standing there. Magdalene was there. It looked like a bad day, bad Friday. It looked like terrible Friday. Maratasa Mashambolazada. A Friday that looked like horrible Friday. I don't want to remember this Friday. It looked like satanic Friday. It looked like evil Friday. But by the power of the word of God, which says that all things work together for good, the name of that Friday has been changed from horrible Friday to good Friday. Good Friday. By the power of the Holy Spirit, horrible Friday has become good Friday. This is a great power of Romans 8:28. To them that love God, the baddest day of your life will be renamed by God. And everybody will call it a good day. Is that not a miracle? It's a miracle. It's a miracle. Good Friday. May every horrible day of your life be renamed, retitled into a good name. Good Friday. How many would agree with me when John was standing there, Mary was standing there, do you think they would ever call it a good Friday? Oh. But today, what do we call it? Good Friday. May this be your story. I said, may this be your story. In Jesus' name. Verse 29. We are trying to read the Bible. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed. You are predestinated to be conformed to the image of Jesus Christ. Can I have an amen?
Amen.
And those he called, he justified. And those he justified, he glorified. What shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Amen. Wow. Is it not good news? If God be for us, who can be against us? Other people in the corridor outside, they should come in. Don't keep people out as prisoners. Everybody outside should come in. Beautiful. Now, verse 32. He that spared not his own son. Are you reading with me? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us. How shall he not with him freely give us all things? You are going to receive all things. Amen. All things. All things. There's no car, house, money, job, citizenship that God will hold back from you if even his son, he gave his son for you. It means he wants to give you a lot of things. Sometimes you look at the biggest gift that has been given to you and you realize that the small ones must not be a problem. If God has blessed us all the way up to giving us his son, then it means that there seems to be nothing that he wants to hold back from us. Amen. Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies. Verse 34. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died. Yea, rather, that is risen again. Who is even at the right hand of God? Who also makes intercession for us. Verse 35. Who shall separate us from the love of God? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword, as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, this is another famous verse. We are more than conquerors through him that loved us. I declare you, not that you won, you are more than a winner.
Amen.
You are more than a winner.
Amen.
You are greater than a winner.
Amen.
You are more than a conqueror.
Amen.
Hey, more than a conqueror. That means you are more than Attila the Hun. You are more than Alexander the Great. You are more than Julius Caesar. You are more than, which conqueror again do you know? Napoleon. You are more than a conqueror. I mean, you are more than Napoleon. I mean, famous Napoleon. You are greater than Napoleon. You are more than a conqueror. Through him that loved us. So God is making you, generally speaking, if I want to summarize your life, you are more than a conqueror. Like, you are a winner. You are winning. All my former prisoners, you are more than conquerors. Like, you have overcome whatever is fighting you, whatever is opposing you. Not that you've won, but it's more than winning. It's more than winning. Yeah, whatever is fighting you, whatever is holding you up, you get it? Whatever is opposing you, you are more than winning. More than a conqueror. Amen. As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long and accounted as sheep for slaughter. We people see us that way, but we are more than a conqueror. Verse 38, for I am persuaded. Oh, yes. I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. What does it mean that none of these things can separate us from the love of God? What it means is that, like, God is trying to love you and people are trying to block it. People are trying to stop it. Somebody is trying to oppose it. Somebody is trying to resist it. But God is telling us that I now know that I am persuaded that neither death nor life or any bad thing, powers to come, demons, principality, height, depth, creature show, will ever be able to block and separate when God is trying to love me and something is trying to stop it. It's not going to work. God's loving me is not going to be ever be able to be blocked. God's love for me is going to work. Neither depth nor height nor princes nor anybody, height, depth, or any person can block me. If God is loving you and he's sending a very nice, handsome beloved to marry you, beloved, he's trying to send you a beloved to marry you, and somebody is trying to come called Christina, she's trying to come between you and this beloved whom God is giving you. Are you listening to me? This verse is saying, I am persuaded that neither death nor life nor Christina, you can't block it. What is for you that God has given you, you can't change it. You can't change what God has given me. Nobody can stop it. If God loves you, if God has called you, God intends to love you by putting you in the ministry and using you in the service of God. Nobody, no James, no John, three Johns cannot stop you. And separate you from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Lift your hands right now and receive this love from God. God loves you. God really likes you. And God really wants to bless you. Father, thanks a million for your beautiful love that you've shown to us today. Thank you that nothing can separate us from the love that you have for us. We love you, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. We thank you. Thank you. We receive the love. We receive the call in Jesus' name. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Now listen, everybody say the love. Every standing. We are just about to take a break, but I want you to listen. Every standing. This is the love of God for you. Listen, this is the love of God. This is the love of God. Are you there? Yes. An important call. Can you imagine getting an important call? Somebody is trying to give the person a wrong number. So the person is always ringing another number. Let me tell you something. This is God's love for you. His call. He's calling you. He's calling you. He's going to use you. You are not going to be an ordinary Christian. You are not going to be an ordinary Christian. He's going to use you. And actually, he's calling you. Oh, yes. Yes. There's a call coming. There's an important call. It's more important than any phone call. But it's a call. And nothing can prevent you from getting that call. How many sometimes you heard that somebody called and you said, oh, why didn't it didn't get through. 2 days ago, I had a call from the pastor of the largest church in the world. And I got to say, he said, he's trying to reach you. And I was excited. Oh, wow, I'd like to get that call. I'd like to receive that call. But nothing, maybe he got a wrong number or maybe he, I don't know how come. So three different people were calling. Said, he's trying to reach you. This man is trying to reach you. This man is trying to reach you. I want you to know that a very great person called Jesus, you know, is trying to reach you. He's trying to get a call out to you. He's calling you, and nothing will stop a and block the call from coming through. It's going to come through. It's come through already. It's coming through for you. He's calling you. He likes you. He's chosen you. He's going to use you. 2 Timothy 1 and verse 9, he saved us and called us. He saved us and called us. Now receive. Put your hand on your ears right now. Your hand on your ears. May you receive the call. May you receive the call. The very important call that's coming through for you. A very important call for your life. Receive the call. Receive the call. Receive the call. Receive the call. Rostale shibosa. 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 Hambrosi parsamana mandabara samandara. Now put your hand on your heart. Put your hand on your heart. Your heart is also going to hear. Oh, nothing will block your heart from receiving the call. Beautiful call. The call of God. The call of God. The call of God. The call of God. Receive the call. Receive the call. God likes you. God likes your color. God likes your tribe. God likes your background. God likes everything about you. He's choosing you. He's calling you. You're going to receive that call. You're going to hear that call and do His will and obey Him. This is His love. Nothing can separate you from the love of God. Thanks, 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 Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Take your offering. I think I need a chair on stage always. Take your offering now. Listen, nothing will separate you from that important call that you are getting. Nothing. 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 There's an important person who's calling you. That's God's love for you. It's going to come through. It's going to come through. It's going to come through for your life. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Lift your offering up. Now everybody should give. Every giving. We are just taking a short break and we'll come back. This is not a lunch break. We are going to have a lunch break later, but this is not a lunch break. This is just a break. Wee wee and other things. And then we'll be back. Father, thank you as we sow our seed. In the name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. He came through for me. He came through for me. He will come through for you. God is going to come through for you.
What the future brings, who knows where the road will lead. You see, the world can change wherever so quickly. It's an age of uncertainty. Sometimes when you call on the Lord, sometimes He can seem so far away. But I say, wait, you must believe, just wait, He won't forsake His own. Oh no, you're not alone. He'll come through for you. He's never been less than faithful, and He cannot be untrue. He came through for me. I know He'll come through for you. There's a path He's prepared just for you. Oh, He came through for me. He came through for me. Come through for you. Oh, my Lord is the first and the last. My Lord sees the end of all time. And even when life goes beyond my understanding, I'm at peace with His hand in mine. Oh, God knows what the future will bring. God has a plan for me and you. So I say, trust and then obey. Believe it will work out okay. He's made a way. He came through for me. I know He'll come through for you. He's never been less than faithful, and He cannot be untrue. He came through for me. I know He'll come through for you. There's a path that He's prepared just for you. You come through for you. Don't forget His faithful, who promised every word to us. His guarantee. He only asks us to believe, just believe. He came through for me. I know He'll come through for you. He's never been less than faithful, and He cannot be untrue. Even though life's storms are raging, He's the one, He never changes. He'll come through, yes He will. He came through for me. He came through for me. And You come through for you. Yes, He will come through for you. Don't give up, don't give in. He'll come through for you. Just believe in Him. He'll come through for you. Oh, oh, oh. He'll come through for you. Oh, He'll come through for you.
Father, thank You for this offering and this time. In the name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. All right. Thank you. Now, we are going to take a short break for just 30 minutes. Amen. And then we're going to come back. So you can wee-wee and whatever. You want to, what else do you want to do? Amen. How many feel the Holy Spirit is touching your life? Oh, yes. Yeah. How many know that you can make it by the Spirit? By the Holy Spirit. Yeah. Yeah. I've been a Christian for so many years, serving the Lord and working in the church. I'm telling you that it is possible that in 30 years from now, how old are you? 21 plus 30 is what? 51. If I'm alive, I'll be 90 years old. Can you imagine that? But you'll be 51. You'll be a famous pastor. Yes. Oh, yes. By the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will help you to mortify your flesh so that you can continue. As soon as the flesh comes up, we're going to die. That's it. It will be the end. It will be the end. And that's how it's going to be for many. Now, there are many people here. You are called to be apostles. God is going to use you to start churches. Yes. Some of you have in you a gift of traveling. Yes. You are going to be a traveler. That's not a pastor. A traveler. Traveling. Day and night. Moving around. Moving around. Yes. And some are going to, when we talk about the ends of the earth, you are going to be used by God. God is going to use you far, far away. Yes. Actually, some of you have a real exciting life ahead. Yes, exciting life. Yes. And there are people here, you'll never live amongst people you grew up with. Because that's not your calling. Your calling is not a home-based calling. Wherever is home to you, you will not be there. Because God is preparing you to send you and use you with outsiders. You know, over the years, I've been a Christian for so many years, serving the Lord and working in the church. I find some people are international and some people are just local. They are community people. Oh, yes. But I feel here the word, I'm hearing and seeing the word apostles. Sendable people. People who are going to do that. How many of you feel that God is going to use you as an apostle? Stand up. I want to see the apostles. Apostles. Yes. Are going to be used as an apostle, like to be sent. All of you who are standing, no one else should stand. All of you who are standing, come to the front. If you didn't stand, don't stand. Yes. Come, everybody should come. Now, lift your hands. The grace to travel. The grace to travel. Receive the grace. Receive the grace. Receive the grace to travel. To travel. You will remember today's prayer. You will remember today's prayer. You will remember today's prayer. Receive the grace to travel for God, not for vacation, not for vacation, not for holidays, not for holidays, watch out, not for vacations. Receive the grace, receive the grace, receive the grace, receive that grace, receive that grace. Power belongs to God. Yes, 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 yes. Grace. Receive the grace. Receive the grace. Oh, thanks. Thanks. Oh, yes. Thanks. Now, lift your hand and take in a deep breath. Receive it. Receive it. It's flowing. It's flowing. Oh, yes. Yes. Be charged. Be charged. Be charged with the gift. Be charged with the gift of God. Be charged with the gift of God. Be charged. Receive the gift of God. Receive the gift of God. Apostolic gifts. Apostolic gifts. Thanks. 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 On this side, lift your hand. Receive the gift of God. Receive the gift of God. Power belongs to God. Apostles. 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 Yes. 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 Bale shabanda sombo balada la mashando la mege bale. Bale ma shabanda la babada balada 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 balada. Receive the gift. Receive the gift. The gift of God. Watch, watch out, watch out, watch out. Oh yes, you have the gift of traveling. You know, if I've touched you, go back to your seat, please. Go back. If I've touched you, go back, please. Thank you. Listen, I just came from the end of the world, and there is a traveler's anointing on me. And so I am giving you something. Peter said, such as I have, such as I have, give I thee. Receive it. Receive it. You'll be traveling. You'll be traveling. You'll be traveling. You'll be traveling. You'll be traveling for him. For him. For him. For him. For his name. For his name. For his name. You'll be traveling day and night. Day and night. Receive it now. 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 Thanks. Thanks. Power belongs to God. It's happening. It's happening. It's happening. The Father and Son. All of you here, lift your hand. Receive the power of the Holy Ghost. Receive the power of the Holy Ghost. Receive it. Receive it now. If you love me, really love me. Olo Spirito Shibala. Watch out. Watch out. Watch out. Watch out. It's happening. Watch out. It's happening. Hello. Receive. Receive. Receive it. Go. there is somebody, I see you. I see you traveling with me. I don't know who you are. But God is making you a traveler. Lift your hands, people. Wow. Oh, yes. Listen. It's a foundation. It's something very basic. Hands must touch you. Quality hands.
Go ye therefore. Teach foundations. Go.
May God bless you with the grace.
Baptizing them in the name of the Father and Son and the Holy Ghost.
Oh yes. Yes. Oh yes. My God, my God, my God.
Go ye therefore and teach all nations.
If I have touched you, please make way, because I cannot get to the people.
Teach all nations.
If I've touched you, even if I've touched your hand, please go back.
Baptizing them in the name of the Father and Son and Holy Ghost. Go, 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 go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. If you love me, really love me, feed my sheep all
thanks
over the world. If
thanks
you love
thanks
me.
There's real power here. There's real power here. Receive it. Something you don't have. Something you don't have. Something you don't have. Receive it in Jesus' name. Thanks, Lord. Receive it.
Baptizing them in the name of the Father and Son and the Holy Ghost. Go, yeah, yeah. Go.
Somebody is going to be a missionary in Singapore. I don't even know who that is. Lift your hand. You know, no one should join the queue. Since, has anybody else joined? The people who lift stood up, that's the only group that should be here. Because I see this side is getting longer. No, no, no. No new person should join. You are destroying something. If you didn't get up when I told you to stand up, you should not be in this line. Please. Go back to your seat if you came later. Go back, please. Do not join. Do not join. If you join and I lay hands on you, it will not be a blessing. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, yes. That's power. That's power. Look at that. Oh, yes. Thanks. Oh, yes. This group is apostles. I will pray for pastors. But this one are apostles. 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 Travelers. 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 Travelers for God. Jesus. Jesus. Thanks. Thanks. Thanks for the travelers. Oh, receive. Yes. Power belongs to God. Oh yes. Thanks. Listen, 192 nations, even Saudi Arabia. Oh yes, thank you. No, that is the gift that God has given me. When I come in contact with you, it's going to make you be in the ministry. Yeah, that's the gift I have. I mean, there are so many things I don't have. Like, God hasn't given me that grace. But this is one of the graces. That's why I'm laying hands on you. Thank you. Touch his life. Don't struggle. Look at it. Receive it. That's power. What is that? That's power. That's power. You are God.
Jesus,
I believe in you.
And I will go
to the ends of the earth.
To the ends of the earth.
Receive it.
For you.
Lord,
I'm the Son of God.
For you.
All the world will see.
We're not ashamed of this gospel. Enjoying the break time. That's your break. Receive. Power. Look at it. And you see, those who don't believe in the power of God, you can come and stand on the stage to watch. You cannot explain it. If you wonder what is the power of God, just come on stage and watch. Something is happening. Receive. Oh yes. Miracle power. Power of the Holy Spirit. Oh yes. I'm praying for just this middle section now. Who are the people? Receive. Receive gifts. Receive your gift. Receive your gift. Receive your gift.
And I will give the world to tell the story.
Andres Benching Smirigini Mamene. Thanks. Me. Thanks.
I know that you've called
Thanks.
Me.
Thanks. Come. Let them come.
I've lost myself, but good within your promise. I won't hide.
Lift your hand.
It.
Thanks. Thanks.
I won't hide.
Watch.
It.
Watch. Receive
Jesus,
receive the gift of God. Receive
you,
the gift of God. Power.
Go
look at it. Look.
To the ends of the
look
earth.
At it. Receive
the
gift. Receive the gift. Receive the gift. There's power here. There's power here. There's power here. There's power here. Receive the grace of God. Receive the power of God. Receive the gift of God. Receive.
Jesus, I believe in you, and I will go. I'll go to the end of the earth.
Thanks. Watch this lady.
To the end of the earth.
For to the end of the world.
Alone, I'm the Son of God. All the world.
Jesus.
And you
Jesus.
Are God.
Thanks. Now, are those of you in the yellow uniform part of those being prayed for, or you are different? You are ashes. So I shouldn't lay hands on you, isn't it? Lift your hands. Oh, young lady, God loves you. God likes you. Orende Spelino. No, no, no. God loves this lady. Receive. Be blessed, my dear. Take the gift of God. Take the gift of God. Yes. Power belongs to God. Come back. Come back. Receive power. Power. Shkele Baba. I believe in you, Jesus. I believe in you, Jesus.
For you, alone, I'm the Son of God, and all the world will see that you are God. You are God.
Lift your hands. All right. Now, there's a wave. There's another wave of apostolic grace. Listen. Thank you. How many times since the last 30 years have I come to England to do a church work? I can count it. But you see, there's a church here. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. There are churches here. The visits, because of the Holy Spirit, has made churches to exist. Such will be the grace on your life. Your visit to an island, to a country, you will change the whole country. You'll subdue nations. Receive the gift of God. Receive. You see, yes, look at it. Because people don't know you. They don't respect you. They don't know who God has made you to be. Receive now God's power. Receive now God's power. Power belongs to God. Power belongs to God, my darling. Look at it. Bring this man back to me. Watch out, look at the girl. There's power here, look. There's power coming out of my fingers. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Receive. Send me, Lord. Send me, Lord. Use me. Use me, Jesus. Thanks.
I'm the one you're looking for.
Look at it. There's power coming out of my finger. Lift her up. There's power coming out of my fingers. She cannot even stand. Power belongs to God. Okay, let's see.
Here I am.
Everyone lifting your hands, holy hands. Oh, beautiful. It's beautiful what's coming on you. It's beautiful.
I'm the one looking for.
Thanks.
I surrender all my life.
Thanks for your glory.
I accept.
Thanks for
the
your power.
Of God.
Oh, can it be, Lord, shame
and glory, man, glory, man.
Thank you. Thank you.
The world.
Oh, are you ashes? Bring this, this gentleman.
I'm the one you're called to serve. I'm the one you've been
You are like David.
To.
You are like David.
I'm the one he gave
they didn't, initially, they didn't call you. Baros Kendo Moshin Baba. Castala Mado. Look at that.
I'm saying here and now.
Thanks. Send me.
Lord, I Look at know that. There's power. To find
There's power coming out of my fingers. People are receiving apostolic grace. Apostolic grace.
Lord, I know there's such a need.
Thanks.
In this lost and dying Thanks. World.
Thanks.
It's time for me
Thank you, Lord.
To say.
Lift your hands. Thanks. There's power. The power of the Holy Spirit. It's invisible, but it's real. It's invisible, but it's real. It's changing you. Oh, yes. My dear, receive from God. Come here. Lift your hands. Thanks.
I'm looking for someone that
Beautiful.
I can send.
Beautiful. Receive the gift of God. Thanks.
Someone to sacrifice his life, his dreams, his goals.
His dreams, his goals.
I'm looking for someone who loves me.
Someone who loves me. Thanks. It's flowing.
Hello.
Oh, yes.
I'm the one you're looking
yeah,
for.
Yeah, los sketchimos esperin
olem. I know it's hard to find someone who wants to go. Someone who wants to serve me.
Oh, yes. God loves you. God chooses you.
Lord, I know it's hard to find.
Thank you. Receive. Wave after wave of God's glory.
Wave after wave.
Thanks.
Wave after wave.
Leave them.
Glory of the Lord.
Thank you. Watch.
Holy place.
Bring her back to me.
Wave after wave.
Receive a gift of God. Thank
wave
you. Thanks
wave.
For your mighty. mighty power, Lord Jesus.
Wave after wave.
Oh, yes.
The power of the Lord fills this holy place. Oh, wave after wave. Wave
watch,
after
watch this
wave.
One. Touch, Lord.
Power of the
let the power
Lord
of the Holy Ghost
fills this
lay that down.
Holy place.
Receive it, young man. Let the
wave
gift of God enter you.
Wave,
in the name of Jesus.
Wave after wave.
Wave after wave of the power of the Holy Spirit. Alama shamandala manda barana. Receive the gift of God. Receive the gift of God. Thanks for the power. Thanks for the grace. That's glory. Thanks for your glory. Amena shambele. Al garaba shambala. Standing. Father, thank you for the gift of God that you are giving to us. The glory of God you are giving to us. The help of God you are giving to us. We love you. We thank you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You may be seated. Now, I heard in the realm of the spirit, apostles. And I believe that many people are going to be sent. Amen. So that's a great blessing to be sent and to be used. Now, I have great faith. When I went to Papua New Guinea, I saw there, right, pastors whom I had a camp with in, what is the name of that camp? South America camp. And others. What town is it we had a camp? Seven Oaks. They were just nobodies. Just nobodies. Yeah. When I say nobodies, I mean nobodies. And then they've become men of God with congregations and members on islands. It's amazing. So that's why I have even more faith in as I'm preaching to you and then laying hands on you and praying for you. I have so much faith that I think you don't even see, yeah, of how great people are coming out of this. We are not ashamed of the gospel camp meeting. Oh, yes. Some will come to Bible school. Some will become pastors. Some are, a lot of changes. Healing of all these past things. Yes. And correction by the Holy Spirit and changes that are deeper than any man can ever change. Your mother can never change you as much as the Holy Spirit is changing you. Yes. And internationalization and world, you are becoming world quality, worldwide. You'll be in worldwide demand. Yes, because of this gospel you are carrying. That makes you international. Oh, yes. So we are not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of this gospel. And I'm not ashamed of the preaching I'm preaching. Yes, because I know the power that it has. It has great power. Because some of you here, you are more than thieves. You are more than robbers. You are more than criminals. But a greater power than any human type of advice has arrested you for God. Are you not happy about this great power? That's what he says. We are not ashamed of the gospel because it is the power. That is actually what is powerful. Yeah, because I can't think of any human logical psychotherapy that is changing your life. Yes. Psychotherapy is a psychiatric word for counseling. When we say we are treating madness, one of them is psychotherapy, which means just talking and counseling the people. Yeah. I don't know any psychotherapy that is bringing you to this place. Yeah. But I know Jesus and the gospel, the power of the gospel. I mean, look at you, a young person. Why are you not smoking this afternoon? I mean, what are you doing here from Tuesday to Friday? Now, have you thought about it, what young people are doing? Yeah. What they are planning to do this weekend across the country? There must be some kind of power that is working. And it's not as though people who don't know things, like people, you've tasted many things. You've tried things. You've been there. You've been in there. You have the ability if you want to. But look at you here. There must be something powerful that is actually working to bring young, hot-blooded people here. Not only girls. You would have said, oh, maybe girls are here. But there are many young men. I think more men than, more guys than girls. Very strong, handsome men. Handsome young men. Whom at least 18 girls would like one guy. And they are all sitting here. Bishop Richard, isn't there something powerful at work? There must be something very powerful that is working on your life. I mean, look at your hairstyles, your dressing, your everything. You are nice. You are beautiful. You're handsome. Ah, I'm not ashamed of this gospel because it's very, very, very powerful. Yes, it has powerfully arrested you. And this gospel arrested me when I was 16 years old. And I've been under arrest. I want Jesus to throw the key away. Yeah. Do you want Jesus to keep the key?
No.
You should throw it away so that it's like no one can let you out. We are chained to Jesus forever. Hallelujah. What a great blessing. What a great blessing. So what time is it now, please? Oh, there's a watch here. All right. 2:11. So I'm going to give you just... How many minutes? 10 minutes. No, that would be... I don't think that is cues. Yeah. So by 2:30, we'll start, and then by 2:30, we'll be regathered. This is not lunch. Lunch is coming. I promise you. They are frying your chicken for you. So this is just a short interlude, bathroom break. And then after that, we'll come and then we'll go for our lunch before we come back in the evening. You know, we are trying to read just a book and it's becoming so difficult. Yes. Is it not amazing? Yes. We're trying to read just one book and we are not able to finish reading it. But at least you can say that you've read the book of Romans before. How many will agree that you've read the book of Romans at least up to chapter 8? Yes. So we haven't yet started the camp because these are not really part of the camp. Yes. We are just trying to continue reading from verse 16. Romans chapter 1 from verse 16. Amen. All right. So God bless you. Please be seated.